Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how a theme decides what to apply to if you've got more than one text box in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever had a theme with more than one text box and you were confused as to why it would apply to what, under what circumstances, go ahead, like, subscribe, and leave me a comment below. So this is kind of a confusing thing. I've been designing some experiments to kind of figure out how to do this, and I think that I've got it nailed down. So let's head over to my computer and I'll tell you exactly what I'm thinking. So here we are in Pro 7, and I actually have a presentation that I made just for testing here. So you'll notice that all these slides look basically the same. Some of the text boxes are, you know, a little higher than others, but in general, they're all the same. So let me select one of these. And we're going to just select all, Command-A, Control-A on Windows. Command-A on Mac is what I was saying. So let's right-click, and we're going to add a theme here. And I'm going to do my two-language theme. First text box, top in Z order. So when I do that, notice basically most of these, the order did not change except for slide 5 and 7. Now, you might be curious, what did I do different with 5 and 7? And that's where it gets confusing. So, let me explain what I did. I'm going to undo that so that these go back to the way that they were, and then we're going to go into the editor. And for the first one, both of these text boxes are exactly the same size. The text is different sizes, but the text boxes themselves are the same size. And it's in order. This top text box is the top text box here. And this bottom text box is the bottom text box here. And notice that they have the same name. For the second one, I changed them to different names. For the third one, same name, but this one is bigger than this one. For the fourth one, I did this one is bigger than this one, and they have different names. So of those three variables, I'm changing one in each of these situations. So let's go down to 5 here. And in number 5, if I select this first text box, notice it's the bottom one in Z order. And if I go to 7 and I select this, it's also the bottom one in Z order. But in this case, I've got the bigger, it's a bigger text box. And in this case, they're the same size. So in this case, what's happening is that ProPresenter is saying, okay, whichever is the top of these two text boxes, then I'm going to apply from my theme top to top, bottom to bottom. Okay. I thought that it would also match the name of the text box, but I found that isn't necessarily the case. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to tdm.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. So when I go back here, and let's apply that theme again, go into themes here, go to my new language, and first text box in Z order, notice it affected 5 and 7 here. Now when we go into the editor, what's going on is that it not only affected the top text box in Z order, it also renamed it. Well, it renamed text box 2 as well. So, and same thing for 7. So it renamed the text boxes and made sure that their order here matched their order here. So it seems to me, but you might think, well, okay, then it's Z order that's the most important. But if we go back here into show mode and go to undo that and right click in edit here, slide 6 is also reversed Z order. And slide 8 is also reversed Z order, and it didn't do that. So in slide 8, the top text box is the larger of the two text boxes. And in slide 6, they're exactly the same size. See? So somehow, in the case of slide 6, it knew which was which. It just basically applied it Z order in this case, since they're both the same size. And in... wait. No, that's not Z order. Okay, it did not apply it in Z order. So it applied it in slide order up here, where and notice how they have different names. So it seems like it's smart enough to know in general where to apply stuff to. But if you change the Z order and the text boxes are named exactly the same thing, then it gets a little confused and it switches stuff. If that you change the Z order and one of them is much bigger, then it gets confused. So either of those things are what affected. It doesn't seem to be affected by the name of the text box like I thought it was, except if all the names are identical. Then it goes with that, it changes in that situation. So all that to say, more work needs to be done to figure out exactly what's going on, but I think just in general, you want the order to be the same, the Z order to be the same, and you want the relative size difference to be the same. So if you have a if you have two text boxes that are the same size, that's fine. But if you go to the new theme and you have, well, in the slide, if one text box is huge and the other is small, then that can affect things as well if the text box names are the same. So, a little confusing, I admit. I almost didn't record this, and I may not put it out. We'll see if more experimentation shows that it's different, but you won't know it if I didn't show it. So, anyway, that's just some of the things that I've figured out in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you would probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7andquick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.